So I wanted to upgrade my memory of my Ryzen 7 Windows PC. I have 16 gigabyte dual channel sticks right now of this HyperX Fury Memory from Kingston, which I'm plenty happy with. So I just wanted to get another 16 dual channel memory kit. But unfortunately, the old model, as you can see here on the screen, is no longer available in my country from trusted resellers. So I ended up going online, of course, searching the web, and found several sellers on eBay selling exactly the models that I had. And there were plenty sellers selling the same models. I just found the cheapest one, as you can see here, two sticks for around $100 free shipping. Had a lot of great reviews, though there was a few of those reviews that claimed that they were fake memory, but the vast majority was happy with their purchase. So ended up trying to buy one of these. So let's have a closer look and see what I actually bought, if these are actually real or fake memory. So come in this bubble wrapper here, very nice, protected actually, and also had fragile sticker on the packaging itself. And you can see right off the bat, they don't come in the original Kingston case or the original Kingston packaging, just these black individual packaging here. So match pair, I don't really think they are, but they're not really sold as match pair. So let's have a closer look at the stick themselves. First impression is very good actually. So first impression, I can't really tell if these are non-genuine fake Kingston HyperX Fury memory. Looks very authentic and looks to be actually well made. You can see Fury HyperX logo right there, and also has that nice heat spreader on there. Not really anything alarming as of yet, at least. Looks to be pretty much authentic. So this is the packaging you get originally when you buy HyperX Fury memory from Kingston. And you can see it's pretty much, oh, it's vastly different than the package that I received here with the two separate DIMM slots or DIMM modules. But anyways, let's just remove one of the original ones from my computer and have a closer look and see if there's any different differences between the original that I know for a fact is original Kingston from an authorized seller. First off, let's try and weigh these just to make sure they actually weigh the same. That's always an easy way to distinguish between real and fake. You can see 33.5 gram, and the non-genuine module actually weighs around or exactly the same actually, so there's no distinguishing factors in weight at least. Let's dig a little deeper and compare the two. So tell me, which one do you think is the real one and which one is the fake one? Spoiler alert, the fake one is on the left, and yeah, it is a fake one, but you really have to look close to find those differences. Not only can you see the color is a little different, but that could just be a manufacturing thing. And the heat spreader actually looks to be pretty much identical. I believe they even maybe comes from the same mold. So yeah, first-hand impression looks to be nice, or looks to be very close to the original one. You can see the original one here on the left versus the fake one. You can see there is not the same components on the PCB, the lower part of the PCB right there. These are the same size of the memory modules. So you can see there was this long row here of components on that side, on the original one, on the back side here as well. Not the same components and not in the same locations. So definitely not the same generation of memory at least. Maybe it's a newer batch. But if you look a little closer, you can see the fake one here on the top where the heat spreader almost touches the PCB. The original Kingston on the bottom here has some kind of foam protection on the inside of the heat spreader. The fake one does not, and you can see it almost bends all the way down to the PCB if you look at the top row there where the heat spreader is on the PCB module. Also has a more greenish tint if you look at it from this side than the original Kingston memory. It has different components, and you can see here on one side, I don't know what these components are, but 150, 150, 150. These are not on the original Kingston memory. They uses another manufacturer or other kinds of component. You can also see there is some bare aluminium on the heat spreader here, right under the X, actually in both sides of the heat spreader, which again is not found on the original Kingston HyperX. The whole heat spreader on the Kingston HyperX has been properly painted. And of course, the model number is just not existent. If you make a Google search, nothing really comes up except for weird third-party websites. And of course, eBay and AliExpress can't find it at all on Kingston's own website. So that's also a dead giveaway that these are, in fact, fake modules. Another dead giveaway, of course, is plugging the module into the computer. Was a little worried, actually, it will damage my module or my DIMM slots, but in fact it did not. But you can see here, counterfeit on the left, the fake ones I bought off eBay, and the real Kingston on the right here. And you can see definitely there is some differences. Not only are the counterfeit ones supposed to be cache latency 18, which it is definitely not, doesn't even have an XMP profile for that 3200 megabyte or megahertz and cache latency 18, but also the name of the module, or the part number, excuse me, of the module is actually just counterfeit. It's a Memron part number, Micron part number. It does in fact have Micron DIMMs on there, but it is of course supposed to be a Kingston. You can see the original Kingston part number here on the right has a proper Kingston model name or part number versus the left one here, the fake one. So yeah, that's a dead giveaway. Doesn't have a Kingston part number. Serial number is probably fake as well. Doesn't run cache latency 18 as advertised, and does have Micron memory sticks on there, which the original ones to the right does have as well. But I believe that that's probably some very bad bin Micron memory they have put on there. And you can see even the label is different. The real one on the top and the fake one on the bottom here, you can see the Kingston label actually is also different. But really, you have to look close to actually see this. And if you don't plug them into your computer and go into CPU-Z and dive a little deep into the model number and look at the latency times and such, then you probably would be, or would think that this was a genuine Kingston memory. At least a lot of the great feedback or positive feedback that this seller had been exactly for this module. And I believe maybe 95% of people who buy these will probably not know that they are in fact not genuine. So definitely be careful out there. There are fake HyperX Fury. I don't believe there are any fake of the newer models, but I definitely recommend you stay away from those eBay and AliExpress HyperX Fury sellers. You are most likely going to end up with the same fake DIMMs, and I'm definitely not going to put these in my computer. Actually, I went out and bought a brand new 32 gigabyte dual channel kit from Corsair instead, because I wanted to have matched memory and I couldn't really get the old model here from new in my country at least. So yeah, stay away from these. Definitely not worth it. I hope to see you again in a future video, but that's been it for this one. Take care.